I'll never go on another MSC cruise again, like not even if you paid me. Now I've cruised on the MSC Sinfonia, the MSC Opera, the MSC Orchestra, and the MSC Splendida has got to be the worst cruise ship I've ever experienced. Now although I've traveled internationally before, I've never traveled alone. And this time I was doing it with my cousin. It was going to be our first girls trip, just she and I. Spending weeks of planning, swiping my credit card because my freelance money didn't come in as yet to pay for it. Super excited, but it ended up being the worst trip I've ever been on. We got to the airport 2 hours earlier so that we could prevent a stressful situation when we both traveled on the MSC Orchestra last year. In fact, this was overall number one worst experience I've ever had during any of my travels. So we thought we'll get to the airport, have a bite to eat, and then I'd be off. Only we got stuck in traffic on the way, and then at the airport got lost in the parking lot because it's not designed for dummies. I tell you, you follow the sign to the parking lot and before you know it, you're exiting the airport. We tried again and found our way back into the airport, and by the time we found parking, we only had 20 minutes to go. So we said the I love yous and the goodbyes. And a part of doing this trip alone with my cousin was because Travis and I needed some space in our relationship. We watched a lot of podcasts, and time away really does make the heart grow fonder. So since we work, live, and date together, we thought, what an opportunity. Plus, although I've traveled before, I've never traveled internationally on my own. So this is something that I want to achieve for myself. I mean, I guess if you think about it, I did that, right? But in the most horrible way ever. Okay, so now we're in the plane and I don't really enjoy plane food. Plus I'm meeting my dad and my stepmom for dinner. They're fetching me at the airport just to take me for dinner, and they're gonna drive all the way back home, which I thought was really cool. So I just took this snack for my baby cousin. We had a really nice dinner, and then my cousin fetched me. We got to my granny, packed our suitcase, and the next morning it was cruise day. Waking up here, it all felt so nostalgic because this used to be my actual room, my bedroom when I used to school here. And so waking up here, I just felt so comfortable. I just felt at home, and my mom made us chicken curry snack wedges, which is if you're brown, you know, you just know. I did a video here just to post on TikTok because it's memories.
Make sure, I just have to make sure.
As long as I come out nice.
you don't even let me.
But, and then we could see the ship. It was so exciting. We were taking videos at this point, screaming, shouting. Oh, it was the best feeling ever. Like, hashtag girls trip.
Yeah.
The lines were incredibly long, but this was nothing different to the Sinfonia, the Opera, or the Orchestra. We took some pictures before we could leave, and then my ma saw some connections and then got us into the line, so we didn't have to start right at the back, which was pretty cool. Not right, I know, but pretty cool. In any case, they were taken from the highest deck first and we were deck number 11, so we would have entered in our section in our time slot nonetheless. Line through customs and passport control was pretty much the same with all of the ships. In fact, it had improved this time around with the Orchestra and the Splendida, because initially with the Sinfonia you were operating under tents, and if it was raining, it was raining on you. Here at least you go through shaded from the sun because it was very hot in a building. The lines are long nonetheless, but you don't blame them. They're trying to get like 3,000 souls on board in a short period of time. Now we're about to board the MSC Splendida, and this is where everything goes downhill. Off the bat, you would notice that there was a huge shortage of staff, because unlike the other three ships, there was no one to welcome you or guide you as to where to go. But it's fine, it's a new ship, you're gonna explore, it's okay. This ship had three different elevators, all souls that are now embarking on the Splendida only knows of the one elevator. I just wish there was like a signage directing you to the other elevators, or maybe just one crew member redirecting us would be nice. They said our cabins will be available from 2 o'clock, but we had about 3 hours to kill. By 2:30, it still wasn't ready, so all 3,000 plus souls were wandering the deck and the buffet. There was no space at the buffet at all to sit. So wherever you could find a spot for you and your hand luggage, that's where you'll settle your stuff, go ahead, fetch your food, come back to the spot. Chances are it's still gonna be there, because let's face it, everyone's there just to have fun. Now, unlike the other three ships, this ship had a slide. And it was one of the things that attracted me to this ship. In real life, it was an anticlimax. The slide was only operational at certain hours.
And where it goes? It comes out here.
And the slide doesn't end in a pool. You end up at a wall. So you're just facing a brick wall. So kind of weird. I mean, this ship took $55 million to build. That's nearly 10 billion rand. And people spend thousands and thousands of rands just to go on an international trip with their family and loved ones. They could have a slide that goes into the water and that's operational. These sunbeds, you had to pay for. It's a sunbed on a cruise ship. I remember laying on sunbeds on the Sinfonia, the Opera, and it was just available for you to use. These sunbeds were on the highest level, deck 16. Now imagine what a view, right? And for pictures. Also, while we were there, the guy closed the area because he knew no one was going to hire sunbeds because it was late in the afternoon. So he just closed the area, like we weren't allowed to explore any further. There was also a restricted area in the front, so you couldn't explore. We finally got access to our cabin. The cabins were lovely.
Our cabin, guys, look how spacious. Very, very cool. We got a nice double bed, massive mirror, really cool balcony room. We got couches, nice desk area where we'll do makeup, TV, thingy station, a mini bar. People are gonna try. It's like, you see why I don't like answering phone when I'm recording. And our balcony. Step out. Michelle booked the premium balcony. Very cool. Great room, Mish. Well done on booking it. Can I show the bath? Bathrooms are pretty much standard in all the cabins. The shower curtain will attack you and everything, but it's all good. Towels. Very nice. Very, very nice. Time to get our vacay on. Only not long after that, my opinion changed because we saw sand on the couches and on the balcony floors as well as the cabin floors. Now, that tells me that the people that stayed in this cabin before us went to the island, came back with the sand, because there's no sand on the ship, right? And it means that our cabins weren't properly cleaned. Now, I am very, very finicky when it comes to the cleanliness of the hotels or any place that I travel and have to stay at. So this was highly cringe for me. We were gonna speak to the staff, but really we're there not to complain. We just wanna put up, it's a short vacation. Let's just have fun with it, you know? But truly, I don't remember having a cleanliness issue on any of the other three ships. They also didn't announce when we were leaving, which was kind of sad. On previous cruises, they will let you know when we're about to leave, everyone will rush up to the deck and wave goodbye to everybody. And it's just a nice experience, you know. Here, one thing you were at the port and the next thing you're moving. The orchestra and the Splendida does have a better emergency drill process in that you can watch it on your TV and then you just gotta go swipe your card, which is a long process as well, and it's difficult for the older folk. You're not allowed to use the lift, so you gotta walk up or down those stairs. But this experience here during the emergency drill, I found it very enjoyable on all four ships. Room. That's spectacular. You don't spin it. We'll be right back. My cousin was so exhausted from the heat and the walking last night that she actually passed out on the couch. We went up at 6:30 and the dinner at the buffet was now open. So we had a quick bite there and then we said we'll get to the restaurant at 8:30 because that was our seating. But after we were done at the buffet, there was no theater show on the Friday, no deck party or any other sort of entertainment. And we don't gamble, so we didn't go to the casino. So we ended up going back to our cabin, having a drink there. But then she ended up passing out because she was so exhausted. So we woke up the next day in beautiful Mozambique. We got dressed and took some pictures, which was a huge mistake on my side because I thought that the breakfast, like the other ships, will be available until 10, 11. But the breakfast at the restaurant closed at 8:30. At this point, we didn't know we were enjoying the island of Mozambique or the view of Mozambique. And breakfast was rough. Let me tell you, breakfast was rough. And because they closed off lunch yesterday, everybody thought once you leave the buffet, you won't be allowed to come in at a certain time. So nobody wanted to leave the buffet area. It was brutal. Michelle and I had breakfast standing up. Very average breakfast. You'll see that I don't have much recording of food because I was waiting to record new images of food, but the food was pretty much repeated. So much so that we didn't even have supper on Sunday night or breakfast on Monday at this
moment. Mish and I didn't go to the restaurant last night, so we said we'll go to the restaurant for breakfast. We arrived there at 9 o'clock and they said that the restaurant is now closed for breakfast and that you should go to the buffet upstairs. So we went to the buffet, which is where we've been eating from yesterday. It's fine, but it is jam-packed. And now it's jam-packed because the restaurant breakfast closes at 8:30. So everybody had a party last night. Everybody did their thing. So everybody's waking up late. Now the buffet is jam-packed to a point where there was no seats, as you saw. And now people were saving their seats. I can't believe how inconsiderate some people are, like seriously, and they are my community. Do you understand that? There was this lady that just came, she didn't come to cut in line, but she just came to ask for a bowl. And the woman in front of me totally ignored her, pushed her way forward, and didn't just allow this lady to just grab a bowl past her. It's like, what the hell? So I let her put her hand in front of me just to grab a bowl. Like, you're just grabbing a bowl. Like, oh my word. Then, this other family, and I don't blame them because once you leave the buffet, there's a lady standing outside saying you can't enter at a certain point. So everybody that's in can eat what they want and finish up and take their time and that. But the minute you leave, you can't enter. So the people don't want to leave. So the people are just sitting there holding chairs for their families or friends or partners or whatever in order so that no one else will get the chairs, you know. And so Mish and I had to like have breakfast standing up. Okay, fine, like we're young, we can do that, but you know, it just these rules that the ship has implemented has just caused people's reactions and behaviors to be selfish and non-pleasant. It's really, if it wasn't through Michelle, this would be the worst trip out of all four. Sinfonia was amazing, opera was amazing, orchestra, that's when the rules started coming in actually, at the orchestra with the booking tickets and the drink tickets, and that's when the rules started changing. But on all three ships, food was unlimited, and throughout the day, throughout the whole day, even though you would have breakfast sections and lunch and dinner, in between they would serve you pizzas or burgers or hot dogs and that. Here, closes. It just closes. So for a period of time, there is no food. So if you didn't fill your gut, you just gotta wait for supper. I don't know, it's just not pleasant. There's hardly any workers around to like help and to direct people. And when you find a spot, the tables are like dirty with the dishes from other people that now have left, and it's not getting cleared up, so you can't really sit there. Or if you want to sit there, you've got to sit with other people's dirt in that, because there's no one walking around cleaning up for you. Very unpleasant. So now we're here, we're anchored in Mozambique, and they're not sure whether they're gonna let us get off because of the wind. But let me show you how windy it is. You see how much Michelle's hair is moving? That's all the wind that's there. Like, is it really that windy not to go to the island? I don't know, guys. Look at the water. I don't know, but we're gonna go. We're gonna try and make the best of the situation. Let our food digest. We just ordered or asked for toilet paper to be brought to the room because they only gave us one roll. And then we're gonna go up to the deck because it doesn't feel that windy. We're gonna have a cocktail, take pictures, and yeah, just make the best of the day. Our toilet doesn't flush. Okay, thank you. Bye. They're gonna send someone now. They're gonna send someone.
Yeah, but there's not number two or anything there. It's just
toilet. That's fine.
Yeah, but it needs to be flushed down.
Yeah, I know.
Because then we can't use the toilet out there.
You see that there was sand here?
Was there?
Yeah.
And I slept there.
And you slept there. Shot of the clouds.
We gon' live it up. She made me beg for it till she give it up. And I say the same thing every single time. I say you the fucking best. You the fucking best.
Waiters, so you're gonna stand in line to buy alcohol. So you gotta stand in line to pay, then go to the bartender to fetch your alcohol. So there's always a line.